Welcome everyone once again to the chapter Ratio and Proportions. So here first let's revise the topics which we learn in this chapter about the introduction part of the chapter. First thing, so the ratio and proportions. The basic thing about ratio and proportion is a ratio is a comparison of two values. Suppose we can take one example here. There is a class. In that class, suppose 12 girls are there and 18 boys are there. So the ratio of the girls to boys will be 12 divided by 18. So if you expressed this ratio, if you reduce it into lowest form, you can find the answer 2 divided by 3. So the ratio of boys, girls and boys will be 2 divided by 3. And we can write this as 2:3, and the proportion is the equation stating that two ratio are equal. So as like 12 by 18 is equal to 2 by 3. So this is the equivalent numbers or equivalent fraction. So this is known as proportion. So this is the concept behind ratio and proportion. So ratio is the relations or just one divided by another, and the proportion means the relation between these two values. So now here in ratio there are two quantities. Okay, one, suppose here I am taking A and B. Okay, so we can write this in fraction is A divided by B. Okay, and in ratio we used to write A:B or A ratio B. So here the two terms is the first is the first term which is A, and second is the second term which is B. So the first term is called antecedent and the second term is called consequent. So this thing we already learned in our previous video also about the antecedent and consequent. So now for example here 5 by 9, so in 5 by 9 5 is the antecedent and 9 is the consequent. Okay, so this is the basic concept. After then, we have already learned the two properties. That two properties are if we multiply with the same value to the numerator also and denominator also, or if you are dividing with the same value with the numerator also and denominator also, so it doesn't change anything. It will not affect anything. Okay, the ratio will be same. Now, in proportion, what happens is you can see here two terms we have taken in examples. A ratio B is equal to C ratio D. So we can write this as A:B and then C:D. So we say that A, B, C, D are in proportion. So these all numbers are in proportions now. Here A and D are called extremes while B and C are called mean terms. So there are two terms you need to keep in mind. One is extreme terms, which is the first one and last one. And another two are mean terms, which two numbers are in the middle. Okay, so here one relation is there in between extremes and mean is the product of mean is equal to the product of extremes. Okay, that means A multiply D is equal to B multiply C, or B multiply C is equal to A multiply D. So first one and last one, product of first one and last one and product of the middle two. So these will become same in proportions. So this is the most important property of proportions which you need to keep in mind. With the help of this, we can do several questions, several problems of your exercise. Now we are going to discuss some questions of your exercise 8A. So first question is asking, express each of the following ratio in simplest form. So ratio are given, you have to convert this into simplest form. So we already learn earlier that to convert into the simplest form, first we have to find the HCF of those two numbers. So here 24 and 40 are there. So if you find the HCF of 24 and 40, you will find 8. Okay, so whatever the HCF come after the same HCF number, we used to divide with the both the number. So here in numerator also 24 and denominator we have 40. So we will divide by 8 with the numerator also and with the denominator also. So after dividing, you can find the answer as 3 by 5, which will be the required ratio. So hence 24 and 40 in its simplest form will become 3:5. So this is how you can reduce into the simplest form. If any two ratio are given, you have to just find the HCF of those two numbers, and after finding the HCF, you have to divide by the HCF with both the numbers, and whatever the numbers, whenever you find that number, that means those two numbers HCF will become 1, and that will be the simplest form number. So here, this is how you can solve question number 1. And question number 2 is also, you can see the HCF of these two you have to find out. But here, before finding the HCF, you can see this is one of the number is in decimal. So first you remove the decimal. Okay, and after removing the decimal, the number you will get is 135/150. Okay, and if you find the HCF of 135 and 150, that will be 15. So 15 aayega, then you have to divide both the number by 15, and then after dividing both the number will be by 15, you will get 9/10. So this is how you can say the simplest form of 13.5 and 15 is 9:10. So 9:10 will be the required answer of question number 2. Next question which we have is the proportions ratio of 20/3:15/2. So you have to find the ratio of these two numbers. Okay, so first we will find in this case, first we will find the HCF of 40 and 45. Here one thing is to understand, what we have done is just we have done cross multiplication. Okay, because we have learned the property that we can do the product of extremes and product of means. So here we have done that only. So 20 multiply 2 will become 40, and 15 multiply 3 become 45. So this is how it comes, 40:45. After find you got the 40:45, you find the ratio of 40 and 45. So to find the ratio of 40 and 45, we used to find the HCF of 40 and 45, which is 5. And after getting 5, we will divide by 5 to the both 40 and 45. Okay. So this is how the final answer will come, 8:9. Okay. So hence we can say that 6/2/3:7/1/2 is in simplest form it will be 8:9. Okay, so this is how you can find the ratio of any two numbers. Now see, suppose three numbers are there and you want to find the ratio of all these three numbers, then how can you do? So here we have 4:5:9/2. So you want to suppose find out the ratio of these three numbers. Okay, so first this will be 4:5:9/2 will be 8, because 2 will be multiplied with the 4 and 2 will be multiplied with 5 also. So this will become 8:10:9. Okay, so after then the HCF of these three numbers will be 1. So as 1 is the HCF, so we can say that the 8:10:9 is the simplest form. This is already in simplest form, so you no need to write in simplest form. Okay, so if it is asking to write the in simplest form 4:5:9/2, simplest form will be 8:10:9. Okay, so this is how we can do question number 4 also, 5, 6 also. So in question number 6, you can see we have 2.5:6.5:8. So these three numbers are here. When you convert this, you will find 25:65:80. So after finding this, HCF will come 5, and when 5 will come, you have to divide by 5, and you will get, if you divide all by 5, you will get 5:13:16 will be the final answer of this question number 6 also. Okay, now let's discuss about question number 2. Question number 2 is also related to the converting into the simplest form only, but here the units are different. Two units are different. If we are talking about first one, it is 75 paise into 3 rupees. So first 3 rupees you have to convert into paise. So as we know, 1 rupees is equal to 100 paise. So 3 rupees will be 300 paise. So that is how it will be 75:300, and 75/300 is equal to 75 divided by 300 is there. So if you find the HCF of these two, you will find HCF is 75. So when you divide 75
by 75 both the numbers, you will get 1 by 4. So this is how the ratio of first one of second question will be 1 paise into 4 paise. Okay. And the next question is also related to centimeter and meter. So here we have 1 meter and 5 centimeter into 63 centimeter. So first you have to convert 1 meter and 5 centimeter into centimeter. So that will be 105 centimeter. So 105 centimeter into 63 centimeter. So when you find the SCF of 105 and 63, it will come 21. So when you divide by 21 both the number, you will find 5/3. So this is how you can do the rest of all questions also of question number 2. So most important thing is to keep in mind to convert first into the same unit. If we're talking about question number 2's third one, one is in hours and minute and another is in minute. So first we have to convert 1 hour and 5 minute into minute. So 1 hour means 60 minute and 5 minute means 65 minutes. So total is 65 into 45 minute. And that is how after that 65 and 45's SCF will be 5. Then we will divide by 5 both the number and will reduce into the lowest form. So this is how you can do the rest of all. First, after converting into the same unit, you can find the ratio. So same way we will do 5 and 6 also. Okay, so here we have in kilogram and gram. So first we will convert into gram both the unit. The kilogram one also, that 2 kilogram and 250 gram will be 2250 gram, and 3 kilogram will be 3000 gram. And after then SCF we will find, so 750 is the SCF, then we will divide by 750 both the number and we will find 3/4 is the smallest unit. And in the same way, 6th one also, in the 6th it is given one is in kilometer, another is in meter. So first we will convert kilometer into meter. So we know 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. So 1000 meter is to 750 meter. So 1000 and 750 is SCF will be 250. So we will divide by 250 both the number and then we will get 4/3. So that is how 4 meter and 3 meter will be the ratio or simplest form of the ratio. Okay. Now if we are talking about question number 3, this is slightly different. If A into B is given 7 into 5 and B into C is also given 9 into 14. So you have to find A into C. A and C ka ratio nikalna hai, aapka A aur B ka diya hua hai and B aur C ka diya hua hai. Okay, so first we know A by B is 7/5 and B by C is 9/14. So therefore we know that A by B multiply B by C is equal to 7/5 multiply 9/14. So here B will be cancelled and A by C will remain. So A by C will be, if you just reduce this into the lowest fraction, 7 to 14 will cancel and in numerator will be 9 left and denominator 5 multiplied 2 will be 10 left. So A by C will be 9/10, that means A into C will be 9 into 10. So 9 ratio 10 will be the required answer. This is very easy. First thing, most important thing you have to understand that we are just multiplying two ratios and BB will be cancelled. And here in right hand side you have to keep in mind that 7/7 and 7/14 we are cancelling. So this is how 9 into 10 ratio will be the answer of question number 3. In the same way, if we are talking about question number 4 also A into B ratio is given, B into C ratio is given. So you have to find the A into A ratio C. So here also we will do the same, we will multiply just and we reduced into the lowest form, we will get A into C as 2 into 5. So this one is also same, but here we have to find the ratio of A into B into C. So A into B is given 3 into 5, okay, and B into C is given 10 into 13. So first we will find, or especially we will reduce into the lowest form B into C. So if you reduce this, that will come 5 into 13 by 2. And after then, when you get A into B into B into C, then you can write that is A into B into C as like 3 into 5 into 13 by 2. So when you again solve this, then you will get that final answer is 6 into 10 into 13. How? Because 2 will be multiplied in the numerator with all the numbers. So then it will be 3 to 6 and 5 to 10. So like that it will be. Okay. And when you multiply with 13 by 2, then 2 will cancel and 13 will be left. Okay. So this is how the final answer will be 6 into 10 into 13. Now next question also is the same. Question number 6.
Okay, so this is also ins to b is given and b ins to c is given. So just first we have reduced b ins to c into the lowest form, then it is coming 6 ins to 21 by 2. Okay, and if you find a ins to b ins to c, then will answer will come 5 ins to 6 ins to 21 ins to 21 by 2. So after then, when you multiply this by 2, all the numbers, then you will get 10 ins to 12 into 21. We have learned that we can divide or we can multiply with the same number with all, for the all this type of fractions. So with using those all property only we are doing. So just whenever you are solving any questions, just keep in mind the properties, you will be able to solve all the questions. Okay, so next moving to the question number 7. Question number 7 we have is divide 360 between Kunal and Mohit in 7:8 ratio. Okay, so the total first you have to check that how much is the total. So total is 7 plus 8 is 15. So this we want to divide. Okay, so the total ratio is 15 and the amount is 360. So 360 first we will give 7 by 15 and to the next we are giving 8 by 15. So first we will find out the 7 out of 15 of 360 is equal to how much, and 8 by 15 of 360 is equal to how much. So first if you find 360 multiply 7 by 15, you will got this will cancel by 24, then it will be 24 multiply 7 168, and again that will also be multiply by cancel will be with 24 only, and 24 into 8 will be 192. So if you divide 360 and if you want to give the in ratio, one person 7 and another person 8, then the distributions will be 168 and 192. So this is how you can solve question number 7. Likewise, same question number 8 is also at like question number 7 only. The total first you have to find out 1 by 5 plus 1 by 6 is 11 by 30. And the amount is given 880. So 880 is first you have to find 1 by 5 of 11 by 30. So 1 by 5 divided by 11 by 30. So when you solve this, the answer will come 880 multiply that it will come 6 by 11. How 6 by 11? That 5 and 30 will be cancelled. 5, 6 are 30. So that is how it will be 6 by 11. Okay. And final answer will be 80 multiply 6. Why? Because 11, 8 are 88. And then it will be 80 multiply 6 will be 480. And same thing if you find 1 by 6 of 18, 11 by 30, so that 6 again 6, 5 are 30, so 5 by 11 will be there. So 880 is that you must. Okay, so next one as will be cancelled. So 5, 6 will be the answer, and again it will be 80 multiply 5 will be 400. So this is how if you divide that 880 into two part, as one is 1 by 5 and another is 1 by 6, then you will get one person will get 480, another person will get 400. Okay, this is how you can solve question number 8. Now moving to the next question. Question number 9 is asking, divide 5600, that is 5600, between A, B, C in the ratio of 1, 3 and 4. So here also the same thing. First we will find the total ratio. Total ratio will be 1 plus 3 plus 4 is 8. And you have to find 1 by 8, then 3 by 8 and then 4 by 8. So 1 by 8 of 5600 will be 700, and 3 by 8 of 5600 will be 2100, and 4 by 8 of 5600 will be 2800. So this is how this is very easy. Question number 9 is easier than the previous one, that is question number 8. So very simply, this is how if any amount is given and if you want to distribute into any fraction, so you can do like this. First you have to find the total ratio, and then you have to find the ratio of 1 by 8, 3 by 8 or 4 by 8 or whatever it is given. Okay. Now this question is slightly different. Question number 10, it is asking that what number must be added to each terms of the ratio 9:16 to make the ratio 2:3. So let x is the number, required number we are adding. So x we will add with the 9 also, x we will add with the 16 also. So x plus 9 plus x is to 16 plus x will be result 2:3. Okay, so now if you solve this, you will get 9 plus x by 16 plus x. So we can write the ratio into like this, numerator and denominator, and is equal to 2 by 3. So if you do the cross multiplication, answer will come 5. So this is how you have to add 5 with the ratio 9 and 16 also to make it 2 by 3. So if you want to make it 2 by 3, you have to add 5 with the both the ratio. Okay. So this is very easy. Question number 10 is also very easy. Okay. So just most important thing is to understand the question. So if you don't know any value, you have to just consider x, and after considering, this is how you can solve. Okay. This question is also same as like question number 10 only, but instead of addition here, subtraction is there. So what number must be subtracted? So let x is the number which we are subtracting. So 17 minus x and 33 minus x is equal to 7 instead of 15. And after again cross multiplication, after solving, you will get the answer as x is equal to 3. So 3 you have to subtract it from both the number if you want to get the fractions of 7 by 15. Okay, this is how. Pause the video and write down and try to understand. If you are not able to understand any question, please ask. I will explain again. Now, question number 12 is slightly different, but it is similar to the 10 and 11 only. But it is asking two numbers are in the ratio of 7 by 11. So let us consider that ratio are 7x and 11x. And if you are adding 7 with each number, that means if you are adding 7 with the first number also and second number also, then you are getting the result 2 into 3. So this is the first equation you need to understand properly, otherwise you will not be able to solve. First, if you got the equation, then the rest of all things are very easy. So after then, we will write in numerator and denominator is equal to 2 by 3. Okay, and after cross multiplication, we will get x is equal to 7. And that is how we can conclude that we have to multiply 7 so that we can get the ratio as 7 and 11. So 7 into 11 will be 77, and 11 into 7 will be 49, and 11 into 7 will be 77. So this is how you can solve question number 12. That's all about today. Thank you. So in homework you will do up to question number 12 of exercise 8A. Thank you. Have a good time. Take care. Bye bye.